Hey guys, we're back, and today we've got our hands on Bose's SoundTouch Wireless Link. This is a great little adapter that transforms any existing stereo, home theater system, or even a music speaker into a wireless player. It works with any of Bose's existing SoundTouch speakers and players, so you can easily group and share audio between new and old devices. In this video, we'll be showing you how to set up your SoundTouch Wireless Link with your chosen stereo or music system using the SoundTouch app. Let's start by opening up the box and running through what's included. Every SoundTouch Wireless Link will include all the necessary cables you'll most likely need to use in the box. The link requires mains power to operate, so Bose provides a power adapter cable, as well as all the international adapter plugs for overseas. Documentation and warranty booklets for further support. Audio out cable, which doubles as a digital, optical and analog. Your standard 3.5mm auxiliary analog input cable. And a stereo RCA to 3.5mm adapter plug. There's a few ports on the back of the wireless link, so we'll just run through what they're for. The power socket for the power adapter. This little setup port you'll only really need to use if you're setting up a wireless link through the SoundTouch app on your computer. Aux in is for devices you want to share and broadcast wireless music, such as from a CD player, amplifier, turntable, or an MP3 player. Audio out lets you broadcast any content played through SoundTouch into a device such as a stereo or a speaker with an analog input. And the control button to activate and deactivate the link's Wi-Fi connection. So we'll begin by plugging the wireless link into power. The link takes a few moments to boot up when switched on. It can only be set up through the SoundTouch app when the Wi-Fi icon is solid amber. This indicates your wireless link is ready to be linked to your Wi-Fi network. You'll need to have the Bose SoundTouch app on your smartphone, tablet or computer, and all new users will be required to have set up a SoundTouch account. Once you have signed in, select the menu icon from the top left-hand corner, scroll down and choose the settings option. There will be an option called Add or Reconnect Speaker, so choose that one. This will then take you to the setup page for setting up a new SoundTouch device. We're going to select Wi-Fi. You will be asked to exit the Bose app and go into your device's Wi-Fi settings, where you will need to select the network starting with the word Bose. Once connected, make your way back to the SoundTouch app and you'll be prompted to continue. You may also be asked to select your home Wi-Fi network and enter the password. Next, you are given the option to name the wireless link. If you're using it with a CD player or turntable, you may want to call it a CD or stereo room or anything you like. You will know if the wireless link has successfully been added to your SoundTouch account if the Wi-Fi icon has changed to solid white. The wireless link now appears as a device to play on in the app. Just below it, there are three icons that let you choose three different ways on playing your music through the app. The first icon selected plays music through the SoundTouch app and any streaming services you have added, such as Spotify, Deezer, or TuneIn Radio. Bluetooth for pairing a smartphone or an MP3 player, and auxiliary for playing content through a wired connection into the device from external sources like CD players and turntables. Now that the link is up and running, we can use it on a speaker or a sound system. I'm going to use the CD player so that I am able to play a CD wirelessly into multiple rooms. You'll notice on the back of my CD player I have an RCA analog out. We want to play audio from the CD player and send that into the wireless link so we can share the music to other zones. I'll use the supplied RCA adapter plug as shown, then attach the 3.5mm auxiliary analog input cable. Whether you're using a CD player, turntable or stereo amplifier, it's the same principle. The other end of the cord will plug into aux in. We can now play a CD through the wireless link. Some stereos though may require you to select an analog out mode first. We'll head back to the SoundTouch app and make sure the wireless link zone is open. Select the AUX icon. You won't hear any sound just yet. This is where we can now group another Bose SoundTouch speaker and play the CD audio through that one. I've got a SoundTouch 20 that's perfect to play the CD through. So I scroll down to select my chosen speaker. The SoundTouch 20 automatically switches on and begins playing my CD. You can add as many more SoundTouch speakers as you like. Each one added gets its own volume bar, so you can individually manage volume for each room. Or you can use the group slider at the top to adjust all rooms at the same time. To remove any of the grouped speakers, simply scroll down the page and untick the speaker. We can also play a device such as an iPod through the SoundTouch wireless link. Using the auxiliary 3.5mm cable and plugging into the link's aux-in port, we can play songs off the iPod wirelessly through all my SoundTouch speakers. Remember to tap the AUX icon first when playing something through the wireless link. If you intend to hook up a non-SoundTouch enabled speaker, you can use a wireless link for the same purpose, only you run the audio out of the link through audio out and into the aux port on the back of the speaker, making sure AUX is selected on the speaker. The method is the same for almost every speaker. Make sure the speaker is switched on, select the AUX input, and play your music through the SoundTouch app. The wireless link is small enough to easily hide away and doesn't need to be on display. Perfect for utilising any home stereo or sound system with easy Bluetooth pairing at the push of a button, the SoundTouch wireless link bridges the gap between old and new, so you can continue using your favourite music players and home theatre systems.